New at 5, driving while pregnant. Seatbelts save thousands of lives every year. So it may surprise you to learn that seatbelts can contribute to fetal injury when pregnant women are in a crash. 12 Nearside's Marilyn Moritz with safety steps to protect mom and baby.
Remember those buckle up campaigns? Those two crash test dummies were named Vince and Larry.
You could learn a lot from a dummy.
Vehicles and restraint systems are designed for average-sized men. That potentially leaves small women, the elderly, and children more vulnerable in a crash. And it's bad for pregnant people.
To address that risk for pregnant women, some companies sell seat belt adjusters or positioners, devices that attach to the lap portion of the belt and anchor between the legs, away from the abdomen. But do they help?
The problem with these seatbelt adjusters is that the government does not set any standards for these devices, and they do not regulate them. So experts still believe that the three-point seatbelt is a pregnant person's best bet, and that any modifications to the car's safety restraint system can be problematic.
Safety experts say your car's seatbelt is best if you wear it correctly. Adjust the seat to have as much distance as possible between the belly and steering wheel. Adjust the steering wheel so you can reach it and the pedals. Then adjust the shoulder belt height and position the lap snugly across the hips and pelvic bone. Don't put the lap belt over the belly. It should go underneath to protect the fetus in a crash. As for the airbags, you should never disable them. And if you're a pregnant passenger, just scoot your seat back as far as you can. Marilyn Moritz, KSAT 12 News.